In this video, we'll be taking the Wasp from Marvel Crisis Protocol from this to this. So let's go ahead and let's get started. Okay, so we're going to be painting the Wasp. We're going to be using her comic book colors of the black and yellow. I really like that look for her. So for this, like we start our blacks, we're gonna do our prime of black, and then we're gonna do some dry brushes over the top of it. So we're gonna get our medium sea gray. This one's pretty straightforward, but then again, I always say that, and then it blows up, so we'll see. I just want to make sure I'm keeping. So it's kind of called out some colors on here. Do the same for the tiny version. Their wings are not attached because they have clear wing pieces. So those would be added extra different separately. And then this little box right over here, let me see if I can get them. Should grab them really quick. So they're right here. I don't want to spray. You don't want to spray those black or anything like that right now, because I want to keep them kind of transparent. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to clip them, and then I'm going to put that that blue contrast paint on them. And I think I should go yellow contrast paint, because I think in the comic book they're more like yellow instead of like that blue energy type of look, which I don't think we want to really have for these. But we will be painting parts of them, so just have them out like that. Put this over here. You can see Ant-Man over there. So we got her dry brushed. I think now we're gonna go into the yellow color. Let's put this over out of the way. Get our brush. And for yellow, we're gonna use good old moon dust from Army Painter. And see if we can't make it, if we don't make a mess. So we got her here. We keep you drop your brush on your shirt. There's some like black between these. Hands are pretty shaky right now. I was rollerblading, and as an old man like me, I ate it and fell on my elbow pretty hard, so hopefully I'm okay. But I'm still and a lot of pain from that. So we'll see how that develops over the next couple of days. It's hard to see the design in here. Then we gotta do little teeny guy right here. Okay. And then we get her shoulder pads in much the same way. I think let's just make sure following the lines that we're supposed to here. I think it's just these right here. Same thing this side. Then we got her little stingers on her wrist. Thank you. Take your time. If you notice you're shaking, just take time to notice the shake and feel it out before you push the brush onto the model. That way you'll get a cleaner line. See here. I think this piece goes all the way to here. Let's look on the back and see what else. Probably little raised bits right here. And there's a little spot right there. Then her knee pads, her knee pads have like a little spot around, but I think I'm gonna do the whole knee pad yellow just in interest of keeping it simple. There we go. And then the bottom half of her, the bottom portion of her shoes, the soles are yellow. So let's just pop those. Oof, the shaking, man. It's getting me today. Kind of roll it onto the front of the shoe here. Kind of roll it there. So we did a decent job there. Okay, let's get this shoe now. It's okay if we get a little bit on the thingy because we're painting that silver anyway. Let's just go like that. Okay. Now also, while we're here, we're gonna dot the eyes. Since they are also yellow. So we're gonna have, we haven't painted it yet anyway, so let's just get the visor. Okay, that'll work. And actually, while we're here, let's take her wing pack here and get that painted yellow. It's okay if you get paint on the inside, it's all going inside the model, but just try not to thicken it up too much. Okay. That one, and we'll get the little one while we're here too. Now we go to Little Wasp here. We try to get the same kind of level of detail on her. Get the little side bits. Get the knee pads. Get the wrist launchers here. Let me just get her a little the shoulders. Shows that they wrap around a little bit, so maybe we'll have to check on the big model if they wrap around. We have like a little okay. We're getting a little close to the sun here. So let's just stop there. It doesn't look like it really wraps around on her here, but I see in the box art that they do have it. So like right here, let's do okay, so that's our yellow. She, we didn't get her shoes, but they're so tiny, so small, so just kind of do that with it, and then kind of sweep the sides. And then get it. Let me clean it up. Okay. So now let's go to the helmet. So that's our gunmetal. And again, I forgot that it was clogged. get the helmet. Make sure we protect what we got in the eye. So we can have those, the eyes different color. Careful around the eyes. It's okay if we have like a little black line. That's fine. Been watching a lot of Earth's Mightiest Heroes on Disney Plus. It's an older cartoon of the Avengers, and it's so good. So there's that. Let's also get the girder that she's standing on. I almost wish they were still on, like, these guys were on the same base. So, like, she's on this, like, girder, but the little one's on, like, a little piece of rebar. Like, I wish they were, the other one was on the girder, too, so you can kind of get, like, oh, like, that's how much smaller she is, you know? But it's whatever. Still a sweet model. I was watching the Ant-Man and Wasp movies the other day too. First I watched Ant-Man, then I watched Ant-Man and the Wasp. And those movies are fun. You know, they're just fun little heist movies. They don't have to always be like this big epic thing. I wonder if they'll sell like a giant man piece for this too, like just a separate giant man, so you can be like, oh, Ant-Man can also go giant man. Every time I see rebar, it's this like rusted red color, but we'll do this for now, and then maybe we'll go over it with like a bronze color to get it more rusted. Maybe in the MCU, that maybe this is a piece of Ultron. Maybe. Who says it's rebar, huh? Okay. There's that, and then we look at her helmet now. I also want to give her a little red stripe on this, on her side. wanna kind of figure out where to put it. I'll just go there. Between these two here. If we can kind of match that on here, just kind of do like a little red stripe there. Really quick, we're gonna pop into Ant-Man because we needed this to dry to do this. So you get a little bonus Ant-Man footage here of just getting his eyes painted. I think this is gonna be too small for me to get in there. Let's go into some black and just clean up what we have. Then we'll kind of let it sit for like, well, hold on, not let it sit, but we'll just like clean up the just get some of the spots that we went over here. Keep it clean, keep it clean. Or try anyway, you know. You don't have to. You don't have to if you don't want to. But I'm definitely trying here. Like right here, we don't need that on her elbow. It's the little teeny things that you do extra. Okay, then really quick, we're gonna pop in with some medium sea gray and get those bases really quick. We have some. There we go. I have a new one of it too, but I don't want to dig into the new one yet. Oops, let's make sure those stay good. And we just do what we do, and we just lightly kind of brush over the base. Nice and simple. Same thing. Just low pressure on your brush. Just getting it on the model. And we'll take that copper that we said we were gonna do. Actually, I think I have like a rust red, whole red, What's this color? This is pretty busted. Dark rust. Ow. Let's kind of dirty brush that onto the piece of rebar here. Just kind of. Like that. But then jump in and clean up where we got it on the base there. Really fast, just dot the brush in there. Okay. Okay, now I don't know how or if this is going to work, but let's take our thingy, let's clip it, and let's see if we can get our contrast paint on the wings. Give it a good shake. You'll definitely have to let these dry before you put them on the model. Just give it a light brushing. Make sure you preserve that detail inside them. You don't want like any blobs of color, of contrast blocking out what we're doing here. So then we get some nice transparent yellow. Let's get one more clip here. On right there. Same thing. Okay. Put that in our little thing up there. Close it up. Wipe it all off our brush here. And then we're just gonna do like a little teeny wash on the helmet with the Nolan oil wash, just to get the darkness in there. So just kinda get on the helmet. We don't wanna dull out the yellow that we did because it's gonna super dull it out. I think she has enough detail. I don't know. Let's see. Let's find out what happens. Kind of brings it together a little bit. Let's go with it. We'll have to do this over the top of the yellow that's on the wings also, so don't forget to do that part if you're following along. Let me do the same here. Make sure we don't double dip into like wet paint. and that is it. Let's get our little tourney table. Sure, we got, let's put a little bit more wash into the model here. Could we miss some of it? Okay. All right, thanks for watching. See you next time, and as always, like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you next Wednesday.